Hi! What up, y'all? It's Normie's coming at you with a movie reaction. This time it is Saltburn.
Yes. Super excited. We've been told a lot about this movie.
This movie came out in 2023. People were very excited about it. And everybody's like, you guys gotta watch Saltburn. You gotta watch Saltburn. And then all the TikToks was like, Saltburn? Fine. All right, I'm gonna watch Saltburn. You hyped it up enough. We're watching it.
I've seen nothing about
this. I've heard no hype about
this. Yeah, really? I don't know nothing about this.
Like, I've seen this everywhere and not knowing anything about any of the social media posts or reels. Like, I have seen it a lot, but at the same time, don't know shit about it.
They've been good about it. Nobody's been spoiling it on the internet. They just go, oh, you know. They just say, like, it's like, you have to know. If you know, you know, basically.
I think I know.
Those kids with the face in it.
The only thing I know about it is that one dude from Eternals.
Jacob, yeah, the kid with the face.
Yeah.
What kid with the, what's wrong with this
They're
face?
Trying to make him the next Miles Teller.
Mm. Yeah.
Also, Nate. Who was trying to be Nate. The next something, I don't know.
Yeah, yeah, Nate from Euphoria.
And Nate from Euphoria's in it, that's all I know.
Ah, oh, did he pass away? Is he the one
No, you're no. thinking of...
Fez.
His real name was...
I don't remember.
Wilmer Valderrama?
Augustus.
There's no way.
Fun fact though, Barbie lovers out there, pregnant Barbie directs this movie.
Emerald fennel.
I'm pretty sure those are ingredients.
All the spices. All of the spices.
All right, guys. We're watching Saltburn directed by Emerald Fennel.
Yes.
Emerald Fennel.
So excited.
I don't know why that gave me that urge.
All right, guys, this is not a market substitute. Please support the OG content. You might be watching this directly on YouTube. I'm not sure how you're going to publish this yet, but there's other movies up on Patreon. Check
so
this
many
out.
Movies.
So many movies.
Oh, my God.
That who knows when they're going to come on YouTube.
We got
John Wick.
Kung Fu Panda. No, that's already on YouTube. We got Kung Fu Panda on there. We got How to Train Dragon on there.
Toy Story.
No, that's already on YouTube as well.
We have Toy Story.
Emerald Fennel.
She
did this.
Oh, so 4x3, 2. Hell yeah, let's go.
4x3, not 4x3, 2.
I hate you. I fucking hate you.
I wasn't in love with him.
Weren't you? Oh,
Nate. We all love it.
Of course.
Are we?
No. It was impossible not to love Phoenix.
He's Phoenix now, okay?
He's a toxic love.
Let's just forget about Nate.
But was I in love with him?
He's breaking the fourth wall.
No, he could just be being interviewed by someone we haven't seen.
Saltburn!
Hey, I like the aesthetic.
It looks like Monty Python style.
Yeah, it does.
It is British.
Carey Mulligan!
What year is this movie and why is no one on their cell phone?
They got the old-timey aesthetic on the credits themselves. You see how they're like flickering? Mm-hmm. And how old movies used to do that? They're purposely making
looks
it
like
seem
we're
like
watching film.
06, there you go.
Hmm.
Also, the natural lighting in this bitch. I'm digging it.
Hogwarts.
That's what I was thinking.
I know, straight Great Hall. Ron's got himself a howler.
I'm a genius. Okay. I don't even like maths, really. I can just do it in my head. Anything. Ask me something.
Yeah. Nah, you're okay.
Come on.
It's not like I don't believe.
Yeah, absolutely.
Come on.
Please do it.
Can you ask me a song then?
Nah, man, I'm gonna leave you alone.
423. Times
78.
32,994. I have
no way to check
sure. That's me when I ask people to describe lost episodes so I can say the episode. Just do it, man. Just fucking describe an episode.
Sorry, I'm late. Sorry.
What's the other kid?
I'm sorry.
Farley Start, I take it.
What are these names? Farley Start, something quick.
All in English then, isn't it?
Frederica Start, by any chance.
She's my mother.
No, I knew her when I was your age, when we were both here.
She's gonna be thrilled that I'm being tutored by one of her friends.
Oh, no, not friend.
Did you stalk her?
Oh, shit.
More admirer.
Damn.
From afar.
Oh, that's a stalk. We're getting to stalk.
The stalking.
That's no, never like spoke. Shade.
Even mention me.
Okay, that's even more red flag.
Don't even mention me.
Shall we start?
This kid's got all the power in the room.
Sorry, just us. Just a funny word. You used it 7 times.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did. I counted. It's not what you argue, but how.
Great point.
Yeah. Especially if you haven't actually read the book.
He's definitely on one side here.
Oliver. Oh, you were crunchy.
I mean.
No, not you.
Do you know there was a college Christmas party tonight? Like, we wanted to go anyway. You gonna eat that?
No, you can have it.
What?
Why'd you even bring it, bro?
I just wanted to talk shit.
No, I'm not gonna eat it, but I'm gonna keep it. In front of me!
He's a psychopath. It's confirmed. Yeah,
he deserves to not somebody. Be invited.
That is an intimidation technique.
He's gonna kill somebody for sure.
That's how he eats his bananas. Are you admiring from afar now?
You all right?
Yeah, I've got a flat tire.
I think you're hot.
Take my bike.
I mean, it looks like rain. I wouldn't want
Honestly, it's no big deal. I mean, I'll just get it from you later. You're my college, so...
Am I?
Oliver.
Oliver.
Yeah.
Oliver. Oliver, I love you.
He's gonna eat off of this story for years.
Going for a flush. Get me another pint, please, Oliver. Thanks.
He's like, I'm gonna ditch this kid as soon as I can.
That's what I hope happens.
Come here.
Yeah.
Well, let me grab my beer for you.
Yeah, come here.
This is my fucking hero right here. I was just telling everyone how you say it. Shut up, yeah?
Oh, I feel bad now.
No, just left.
Oh, no.
Bro, you gotta invite your homie over. I mean, he sucks, but you know, let them figure that out.
I can't go back and ask them for money.
Not my problem.
I'm asking, could I just pay him tomorrow?
Sorry, mate, you're not even close.
He invited him for a drink and then end up making him pay. He deserves
everybody's
this.
Everybody's paying for every round all the way around.
You might need a hand with these ones, mate. When you drop this on the floor by your feet.
Awkward.
Thank you, Ole!
Uh-oh.
Quit being a hater. Damn, he really did ditch Matheson.
He's been expelled from almost every school in England for sucking off the teachers.
Yeah. Have sucked any teachers off?
Not yet, you haven't.
What? Does it think?
My parents, I...
What?
Don't see them that much.
Why?
Mental health and addiction and stuff. Dad was kind of... Dealing and stuff.
Dealing? Fuck him.
Fuck him! Sorry.
Bro, this is gonna turn him crazy. I can already...
I don't know. I'm like wondering why people are so... talking about this so much. And I'm like, what's gonna happen here?
He's giving off very, like, Joe vibes.
Bro, I'm telling you. Joe, England, they're at Oxford. This is season 4.
Don't be so quick to judge Oliver.
How'd it happen?
Cracked his head on the pavement.
Oh.
Or off his fucking tits.
Is your mum alright?
She was completely incoherent.
You've got to go.
No. Can't miss the exams.
Of course you can miss the fucking exams.
No.
Privilege.
This is all I have.
Maybe you can ask them or something. Right now, it's just like almost rom-com vibes.
Right? Yeah.
But there's something bubbling underneath.
There's something. I'm curious what would happen when he will say no.
The whole cigarette scene threw me off.
We have this tradition, right? When somebody dies, we write their name on a stone and we chuck it in the river.
Something wrong.
This feels a bit fucking stupid now.
No. It's not stupid. Thank you.
Yeah, Felix actually cares about him.
Yeah, it's cute.
Damn, so when he dies, someone will cast an Oliver Stone.
Oh my god.
Did you miss the water?
Well, that can't be good.
Well, why don't you come home with me? Come to Saltburn.
Saltburn.
Oh.
Wow.
Roll credits.
These people come to stay for months at a time.
Damn.
And you know what? If you get sick of us, you can leave.
And I believed him.
Ooh. Into act one?
He looks like that Damn. Kid from that show back in the day.
Tim Toolman Taylor.
Yeah.
Yeah, Home Improvement.
Yeah.
Jonathan Taylor. Thomas.
Yeah.
Pinocchio. You don't look like Jonathan Taylor. You're racist. This is crazy.
Is that a great little truck?
It is.
It is. That's pretty sick.
Mr. Quick.
See, look at all the doors.
Mr. Quick. You're early. You see, the gates were not open. That's okay. We sent someone to pick you up.
Ain't it crazy that he's more broke than the butler? Even the butler's like, well, I know the protocol is. So I don't know, dog.
Oh, they rich.
This is why people fuck with
Not the
Felix.
Fly trap. Fucking chandelier with the fly trap.
Red staircase.
Bro.
I accidentally fingered my cousin here.
Oh! Okay,
it happens.
What?
Dead rally. Daddy's old Teddy, Shakespeare's folio.
Damn.
Shakespeare's what? Folio.
Where's the bathroom?
Your room.
Cute.
How do I get here again? Can I fast travel?
All right.
Oh, no. Mm.
Absolutely not. I don't like that shit at all.
Yep. They'll come after you at night.
Oh, for sure.
McLovin's never existed except the Superman! McLovin!
Okay, it's 2007 now.
Oh, God.
They probably don't have real.
Hey, you psycho.
And both his parents were dealing. God, and his mother's a drunk.
Oh, no.
I mean, babies can be really affected. Traumatized.
Oh, they come out drunk.
Oh, I didn't even recognize Carey Mulligan in that fucking wig.
Pamela, darling, will you go and find Annie and ask about tea?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Get up.
Which one's that? You'll find her, darling, Annie.
I feel like you can't say no to these people, right?
She's been staying with us while she gets back on her feet. She's had an awful time.
Now she wants to gossip. Gossip switch.
I've lost so many friends to addiction. It's the root of poor Pamela's horrors, too, I'm afraid.
And the only interesting thing about her.
Farley. No, she is rather dull, actually. She's I mean, the men, Oliver, you wouldn't believe it. The latest one is some ghastly Russian billionaire. Malignantly ugly, of course.
Malignantly ugly. Ain't no fixing it.
She's my favorite character.
That shit's getting worse.
I didn't even know that was a thing.
And you know, we're delighted to have you for however long it is you mean to stay.
Forever?
Oh, no, I think I might have found somewhere.
Oh, well done, darling.
How will I cope? Well, I could actually stay for a little bit.
No,
darling. Mm-hmm. You must be desperate to be rid of us and find your own place. I quite understand.
Everybody's so passive aggressive.
That's polite for get the fuck out today.
They're all naked.
Why are we naked in the field?
Because no trunks. They said no trunks allowed in the field.
Why aren't we naked in the field?
This is the most mid 2000s song ever.
Are they doing formal tennis?
Why are you wearing that?
Y'all don't fuck with formal tennis? Not a cell phone in sight, just people living in the moment.
Okay.
Oh, not the muffled moans.
You gotta stop watching them fuck other people, my dude.
They keep leaving the doors open.
Why would you leave the door open?
Oh, you can be self-pleasuring, obviously.
I know. Oh, I guess you do. Okay.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, if it's a shared bathroom. That door cracked on purpose.
Why are you moaning so loudly? There's reverb. He knows what he's doing.
Dump therapist.
Are you guys shaming people for their habits?
No.
Yep.
No.
Just for leaving the door slightly open.
And then being loudly when you saw other people around.
God. That water was...
Oh my God, please just leave.
Don't. Okay, I thought he was going to drink the bath water.
Give me that slurp! Guys, in the train!
I can't!
He's still going!
I can't! Make it stop! This is so long!
That is the one thing I knew.
Did he also?
He put his tongue in the drain!
He did!
That was very sexual. He ate that thing out.
Complete waste of time.
Jesus, honestly, let me see her
if
closet.
If she found the right boy... Or girl, I don't care.
What is she even saying? I can't stop thinking about the bathtub.
I know, I'm just imagining.
I think she's talking about her daughter.
I was lesbian for a while. Oh, her daughter, okay.
Why are you being a mother?
Why?
Ooh.
Because you're so fucking beautiful.
Oh. Damn! Are you about to play them, homie? He's about to play them.
He looked at her up and down.
Oh, she's gone. James thought it would be better to peel her away this morning without too much of a scene.
Peel her away like a scab.
You'd think she was a riot to look at her, but there's absolutely nothing going on underneath.
Damn.
These people are ruthless, bro.
The self-pity. The emotional blackmail.
Yes. Yes. God. I was feeling quite guilty about it.
She loves this. Oh,
thank goodness for you, Oliver. Like you're so perceptive.
Who's gassing who?
Oh, he's gassing her all the way up. He figured out what makes them tick now, I guess.
Yeah.
Oh.
I don't know. This just became sinister.
I don't know. The music changed.
He's gonna fuck the entire family, isn't
this
he?
This is what's happening. I'm scared now.
He's gonna fuck everybody.
No. Look at the shot.
What the hell? This is great.
You're presumptuous.
Let's put the shine on his shoes.
Uh-huh. And you're gonna see through a nightdress underneath my window.
What? He had an MGMT montage and now he's this?
Ollie, it's not the right time of the month.
Is there something you think I'm worried about?
Damn. He's a vampire, confirmed.
You are a vampire.
Am I him?
No!
Get in there! Oh my god!
Are you rubbing it on it?
No!
She looks.
I want you to imagine you get kicked out of someone's house because you rubbed their period blood in their mouth and you have to tell people that. Oh, she's into it.
I guess she is. You're running the suit. What are you going to say?
It's a rich people suit. They'll buy it. Not that one. Tom Ford, fuck that shit.
I don't know why people are talking about a bathtub scene. They're only talking about the blood scene.
I'm uncomfortable. I don't like this.
What do you call this? This isn't a snowball. This is a...
bloodbath.
Okay.
Oh,
hot. This is fucking hot.
There is no blood.
Oh, they're so sticky. Y'all gotta wash off.
Yeah.
I don't like this. This is very uncomfortable.
I thought you wanted Felix. Hello? What is this? What was it? Okay.
Okay, it's just a little bit of dry blood.
What a shot. The shots in this movie are really well done.
I'm just...
Bloody hell!
What the fuck are you doing?
Excuse me?
I think we're in the wrong fucking room.
Am I?
What?
Are you going to behave?
When did he become a sexual savant?
He just goes and is like, you're gonna eat, you're gonna behave.
But from being such a shy kid, like, he's got no experience doing this.
Right?
You would assume that, but he kind of grew up super rough. You don't know what his experiences are.
That is the truth.
Okay. He's gonna slide it in there. You need some lube. You gonna fuck your way through this castle, bro?
What happened?
Trying to nink something.
What are you talking about?
What?
Planted it on him, bro.
Did he?
He fucked him and slipped something in his fucking pockets or something, bro?
Thought he just slipped a finger in the bum.
I wouldn't have any pockets on.
God, I wish we didn't have to go to London.
I didn't know you were going to London.
Pamela's funeral.
Pamela died.
What?
Yeah.
Do anything for attention.
The redhead.
Damn.
What?
She died for attention. Can she burn after death? Because that's the salt burn. That was the salt burn.
Get dressed. We're going on a road trip. Wear something nice.
Oh.
Look, Ollie, just hear me out, alright?
No,
just hear me out.
What have you done? What have you done?
Your mom called.
Are they going home?
Oh
my god!
So I thought I.
Why would you do that?
I mean, you've been ignoring your calls for weeks, and I just thought that maybe I could help.
No, you can't help. You can't help.
I'm begging you, please.
Maybe he was hiding something.
I'm not taking no for an answer, mate. I'm sorry. You have to fix this.
Is she abusive?
Yeah, she might be.
Oh, she might know who he is and take.
Maybe she's not a drunk.
Did he make all that up? Maybe the dad never died. Maybe the dad has been dead. You know, maybe he made a bunch of shit up.
This looks like a nice place for like.
This is nice, mate.
Yeah.
This is
not.
Really cleaned up.
Yeah.
This is lovely.
Boy, been lying about his. Oh, I love this. What a twist.
His mom did call
Oliver Twist.
Oliver! He didn't even mean it.
Oliver.
I know her. Who's that? Where's she from?
Tall drug addict. Oh my god.
She looks like she's never smoked a joint in her life.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Phoenix.
It's so nice.
What
to
is
you.
Going on here,
his
buddy?
His father's in the garden.
His father.
He's not even dead.
Did he say he was dead?
And he's so excited. Come in.
Dude, you're so cut off. Why would you lie?
Oh, they look very normal.
Yeah.
Oh, that was in Mykonos. We go every year. Well, not anymore. You know, not now that. Kids are all grown up.
Kids? Sibling.
What the fuck is happening?
He's the top scholar at Oxford.
Top scholar?
The top scholar.
Oh, he's just a perpetual liar.
He's so modest, you know, I had no idea.
And working day and night, and then on top of it all, he's got the uni and the plays.
What do you mean?
I've got these horrible migraines.
Ollie, just take a pill or something, for Christ's sake.
Yeah, I'm with Felix here.
This is great.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Awkward ride home.
You're so caught up.
Why didn't you just leave him there?
Please, let me just explain.
I think the best thing is that you go home after your party.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's too late to cancel it now, and I will see you back at Oxford.
And we can still be friends, though.
No.
No.
Why would you lie?
Weird lies, for no reason.
I just wanted to be a friend.
What about your dad, though?
Right.
You think if he didn't have an interesting backstory like that, that they would have invited him over still, maybe?
No way.
I mean, he invited him over out of pity that he didn't have a house to go back.
And he was like, and so much has happened to you this summer, and like you've kept it because of like his dad being dead and all that shit. Like,
yeah, mm-hmm. I mean.
Without all that, would he have gotten the invite to this?
No, but it's invite to somebody's house. Like, it's not invite to a party. It's just.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, my gosh.
Bro, this guy has just a triptych.
It is.
That was a triptych.
Woo! That's a beautiful bag. Like, what is happening with Duncan here?
Look at him. Dressed to part now.
Is he Loki?
I don't think he's got any, like, multiple personalities. I think this is just who he is.
He ain't done a crime.
Cocaine.
That we know of.
That we know.
At this point, I can't trust him. And he's an angel. Ah!
So
oh, God.
Yeah, no one knows who he is. Like, it's. Who's this party for? You're being sacrificed.
He's not being sacrificed.
he's the sacrificial lamb for this party.
He's the one doing the sacrificing. He's the bad one.
Someone's dead as fuck.
It's Felix, right?
Oh, they're going through a maze.
No one's ever gonna
not in the maze. No, that's not where the maze. Death. Cedric Diggory, save us! Damn.
Oh, okay.
Oh, the statue's got horns too, just like him.
That statue is Satan. Why are we like nothing sexy about that statue?
Is he upset?
He's not gonna fuck.
I don't know. I don't know.
He looks so sad.
Felix.
Oh no!
Everyone puts on a show for Felix.
Doesn't this just prove how much of a good friend I actually am? How well I actually know you? I'm still the same person.
You need to agree and then get out of the maze.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You made my fucking blood run cold.
Yeah, he's not waiting.
Or walk away.
He's got no self-preservation because he don't think nothing bad can happen.
Right.
He should be out of this maze.
Yeah, but
I thought someone was gonna hit the head on the statue or some shit.
Right.
Oh no, did he actually do something and block it out of his memory?
I think he's murdering people in his fucking sleepwalking.
He went back to the statue, didn't
drunken
he?
Drunken stupa,
fucking
mate.
Do? Foreboding music is playing.
Oh my god.
Oh, they're looking.
Did you he drop? Find Felix?
What if Farley
he's
did?
In the maze.
It's my body.
But it has...
There was another statue?
Where? I didn't
see anything.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, come away, darling. It's nearly lunch.
What? Yes. It's nearly lunch?
I mean, they're all having mental breakdowns.
They're in denial.
The coroner's outside and they need to pass the window.
Yes, thank you. Close them.
But, like, don't
I don't
want to see
normally
this?
Like chocolate cake.
Yes, it can be cloying, can't it? Yes. Cold hands, apparently. You have to have cold
not
hands.
Red out of all the goddamn colors. Just pretend like it's not happening.
This is so fucked up.
Maybe I be excused, please.
No.
Will you want me just to eat it like nothing's happening?
What else is there to do, darling?
Anything! Anything!
Molly! Sit down and eat the bloody pie! Just eat it! Eat it! And shut up! Eat the bloody pie!
Jesus!
You're not the only person here with feelings.
Are you sure about that?
I think it's delicious.
Just gonna pretend like it's not happening.
Felix,
say it.
Here we go.
Here we go.
What the fuck are you still doing here? Yeah. Does no one else find it weird?
I would feel guilty too. Guilty. If I was the one racking up lines the night someone died.
Fuck you.
That's not a denial.
Search file is wrong.
Yes.
No.
Oh my god.
We found cocaine in there. He did it.
I won't mention this to the police. That's all you'll get. Nothing more. Ever again.
Y'all don't have a different shade of window shade. This looks crazy.
Obviously the visuals for us, but
I know it's cool. God,
it's so cool.
See you back at the house.
No, go home.
Dude,
I cannot stand this dude.
Is he gonna go fucking get it?
What are you doing?
That's why I threw Farley under the bus, saying he was doing lines and shit.
Stop. What is he doing? Stop.
I promise you guys, if he puts his dick in this grave,
no.
I'm going to fucking flip.
No. It's just anguish.
He just wanna be close to that.
Okay.
Wouldn't have put it past him though.
Bro.
No.
No! This is so degrading to the body.
The body's in a box in the dirt. Still, it's just degrading to the grave.
It's you know, yeah, the grave. Like it's
sizzle. He's gonna jizz. Oh.
He's gonna jizz on the
side.
This was not improvised, was it?
I have no idea.
If it was improvised, it would
have
been
I never have to look this up. I actually really don't. This was
in the script. This is in the script.
No!
He was already hard! He was already hard!
Oh no!
Guys, I want to hear the crying.
No! Why?
Look at those thighs, man. That man's built. His glutes.
You're not going anywhere, Oliver, darling.
Oh, we're Trajan Pro, man.
But you're not leaving us. You're not leaving, Sullivan.
Is that a demand or a question?
Sorry. Your politeness is so grating.
Get the fuck out.
You hardly knew him, Holly. I think you're a moth.
Ooh.
Quiet.
They're also attracted to the
flame. Harmless. Drawn to shiny things. Mm-hmm. Desperate to get in.
Don't put your fingers in my mouth.
You know, he does. From the inside.
You drank way too much.
Yeah. You ate him right up, and you licked the fucking plate.
Get your face out of my mouth.
No!
In the fear boner.
Bullshit.
What's happening?
Toxic. There's a very
Guys,
toxic I want to fuck. Leave
the couch.
I don't know what's gonna happen next.
Like, look, he looks good here. Did he inherit? Like,
I broke her completely.
I don't think so. You can't.
I don't know what's happening.
This he's either talking to the police, or he's talking to the butler, or he's talking
she
to...
She couldn't live without him.
Us?
What?!
She killed herself.
Yeah, that's what the fuck he's gonna say. Awfully convenient.
More rocks, I'm leave forever.
And now he's part of family.
And he was there under for the
family tradition.
He was there for the rock.
There's no way.
Holding the umbrella.
That doesn't make sense. They wouldn't do that.
He's the devil.
I think it's time, Oliver, for you to go home. Discreetly tonight. Nothing. To cause at least anxiety.
Thing, I'll kill you.
The dead is dying tonight.
It would be best if the family was able to grieve in private.
Yeah.
Oh, I understand. I agree. But I just think it's best if I stay.
No.
How much? Excuse me? How much for you to leave and never come back to cease all contact with my
wife?
10 million.
Why?
Because we all have to move on. How much?
That's enough to pay for Oxford and some shoes. And a haircut.
Did he... Did he fall from No,
he actually...
Yeah.
Oh, okay,
if
thank God.
If the dad would have died, I would have jailed immediately.
Yeah.
Everybody's on this man's shit list. Oh my God.
What?
Obituary.
What?
Obituary.
No. He did this on purpose.
Dad
he did this on purpose. He can dig his nails again.
Oliver.
Elspeth.
What a coincidence!
What? You grew up.
He does look way older.
Yeah.
You do forgive him, you do understand.
Of course.
He's so creepy!
Come up and stay.
Okay.
Get salt, Ben. Coast is clear now, isn't it?
What does that mean?
Ma'am?
What do you mean by that?
Yeah, what you talking about?
How do you mean?
I mean, he has grown up, I guess.
I can honestly say that these last few months have been the happiest of my life.
Oh no, he's in not. The money now. Who are you talking to?
Who called it? Someone said he'd go get Rose
and Hype. You got so well.
Excuse me?
He did all of them. He did all of them. I don't care. Yeah. They're not showing or going to explain how, but he did.
He's inheriting everything. All Saltburn, Duncan, all of it.
It's been a privilege to look after you. Just as it'll be a privilege to look after Saltburn.
Bro, he's on some Game of Thrones shit. He's like, I'm going to get that castle.
For all those terrible, terrible accidents.
Yeah, show us.
Yeah, I want to see.
Here we go. From the beginning.
Take the chest.
Please, I don't have any money. Could I just pay you tomorrow?
And really?
I've actually just bought a little flat nearby.
That is just typing gibberish.
Shit.
He did go back. Get it.
That's fucked up.
Stop! Are you gonna fuck her?
He did.
He did.
Yeah.
Yep.
How did he know he would do it for sure? He just had to leave the razor there for her.
Almost none.
Yeah, he might have cut her.
He might have done it too. I don't know. Yeah.
Isn't this the sus though? Like the pipe is out. There's nobody questioning shit.
It's his castle now. He's gonna kill himself. He's gonna be bored in this place.
Yeah, what are you gonna do here?
No friends. He's gonna invite Matthew over.
On the dance floor.
What was the point? Yeah. He's butt-ass naked.
Oh, around the... You goddamn right. It's the only way I'm walking around this bitch.
He did the Michael Scott spin.
Fuck it, I'm doing drugs now.
If y'all would've told me this was gonna end with a floppy cock dance, I would've told you we were crazy, but... Right. It's the least crazy dance. Thing to happen in the whole movie.
That's a one shot though.
Yeah, cameraman's back here like, hell yeah, get it, bro.
Flop that dick.
I think it's really good.
Oh, the play.
That thing. He just played them like toys.
He's got their rocks.
He took all.
You jumped in. Don't keep souvenirs, crazy boy.
I mean, no one knows what that is. It was family tradition.
This is just art in your house.
I mean, now. Duncan was there. Does he still employ Duncan?
Said Duncan, you gonna keep my secrets or you gonna be in the water too, baby? I gotta rock with your name on it.
Do you want money?
See how you gonna do it. Oh, like
well,
this.
That's a one thing.
Yeah, there's that's no all I have to say about credits. It. Fascinating.
There's a Marvel.
Fascinating.
Marvelous.
Yeah, he could definitely be a Marvel villain.
Yeah, go to the end credits. Farley's gonna come out.
Farley will return.
Right? I want to talk to you about the Saltburn Initiative.
I don't know what I was expecting, but it wasn't this.
This was not it. Nope.
I'm kind of here for it. The early 2000s nostalgia. The cinematography was fucking amazing. The acting was amazing. And the story, I kind of fuck with the story.
Same. I do too. It said it was psychological thriller, which I didn't know until like literally when we were looking up the director. It made sense. I mean, some scenes made me like nauseatingly uncomfortable.
I thought you were gonna go over the back of the couch.
I can't do it. I enjoyed it.
Like the period blood in the bathtub scene?
Yeah, some I didn't watch, but some was so unexpected. I was like,
what was worse, really, bathtub or blood scene? Bathtub.
I mean, there was one that was the worst.
Was it the grave?
Fucking a grave? Are you fucking kidding me? How can you compare it to anything?
I didn't even watch it.
It was bad.
The
bathtub was so close up. And he like...
I know. I think the period one was more uncomfortable. And the
grave. We all have our own thing. And we don't Google much. We just Google that.
We Google a ton. Sure, Google it. I don't give a shit.
No, I'm not Googling shit.
Some things are like... kink, right? Like if you're in a period block, that's kind of kinky. If you want to suck, see that on the top, that's kind of kinky. If I catch you fucking a grave, we've gone beyond
kink.
And now it's time to call an exorcist or a werewolf hunter. Because you were fucking a grave.
You compare that to like the cum and blood because that's bodily fluid.
But it's just soil.
No!
It's the implications. It's like if you're like, I like to suck people semen out of tubs, I'm like, okay, you're kinky or weird.
Still,
if
you're like,
all three are weird.
If you're like, I want to fuck a grave,
that's
not okay. If you want to fuck a grave, then.
I think they're all weird. And I think we all can rationalize each of them in different ways, but they were all just such an out there that we weren't expecting.
The period blood thing was like kind of hot. I would never do it. No. But like watching it, I was like, oh.
I don't know. I think it was just. Okay.
You don't put it in your mouth.
Yeah, exactly.
It looked like everybody involved in the blood scene was having fun. And it looked like sipping cum off of the top seemed like he was having fun.
He was having fun on all
but
of it.
It was so unhygienic.
And he was kind of crying while fucking the grave.
That wasn't.
That was a cry fuck.
I don't. Some fucking, I don't know. What that
people
was.
Might lick Walmart toilet seats.
Ah,
no, no, yeah, no. People
that's
do.
Awful. But if you're fucking a grave,
so the graveyard. Was I mean, a one shot a scene, one yeah. shot, all improvised. She was like, I just want to see what he does.
Okay.
All improvised, all one shot.
Then I think he did a really good. She said she just go. I think he did a really good job. My question is what do you guys think the moral of the story is? Right, like. What's the point
don't trust random people and bring them back to your house like that early.
That's where I'm at with that. I think it was a good film, well shot. Some of those shots are like amazing. I'll remember them, all the reflections and whatnot.
Mm-hmm. Lighting, natural light.
And the story went places you didn't expect it to. Mm-hmm. That being said, I don't think I'll ever watch this again.
No.
Yeah,
like it was good.
Is on my list.
I could have gone with maybe learning a little bit more about him.
About Oliver?
Why
did he leave his parents and stuff?
But I guess that's up to us to decide. But I feel like if it would have been a 10 out of 10 for me if we would have known a little bit more about his why.
I think the part where he has his inner monologue or actual monologue and he goes by describing them all as like not having any natural predators. They cut to the part where he's also wearing antlers. Mm-hmm. And like, so he's literally wearing like a costume of a victim.
Yeah, he's supposed to be the prey,
he's like a prey, but he is the one like killing them off one by one. So I don't know.
I think every time the prey can become the predator.
Like, No. Don't I don't think it's,
I mean,
four.
I don't. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't think it's a lesson like, you know, don't have people over. I think it's the story about him. If for me, his why is when they were like, that's Felix. Felix has a house name and a fucking mansion. When he was like, oh, all of those stories are written about my family. When they go to the house and they got fucking lineage that goes back to King Henry, like up on the fucking walls. Like for some British shit, we don't have old culture like that in America because we don't go back that far. But they're like, oh, that's Saltburn. They own that house. They are fucking royalty. They are descended from royalty. And homie was like, I want that.
Yeah.
And he's like, I'm not even that poor. I'm not even from meager standings. He's just like, I want that. And like having a castle is attractive because here's the real talk. How do you get a castle without killing a bunch of motherfuckers?
You inherit anyway.
And you know how they got the castle back in the day for being kings and queens and they was fucking marauding a bunch of shit. I guarantee it. Like, it's just, I get it for being like, for me, I see it as a story of like a really ugly, really dirty, really shitty, like super come up. He's like, I'm only going to get this come up one way.
And he was like so pre-planned it so hard. Because like when we were at the mansion, I'm like, how does he have all this like confidence around like Felix.
Venetia.
Yeah. All of them and stuff like that. I'm like, how did he just turn get all this confidence out of nowhere? It's because he had this all.
He was a lamb in sheep's clothing.
You mean a lamb?
Wolf in a deer's clothing with an antler.
A baby acting like a
wolf. This movie ruined my brain.
I really don't think there was a lesson to this one. It was really
there's a lesson to every movie.
I mean, essentially, it's a thriller, right? Like a lot of questions gonna be left for us to interrupt. Like what his motive was. The end of the day, like he wanted the castle and he was a sociopath and just like. That's what I want. I'm going to do all the steps because he was raised, like, it's not even, like, his background, like, his family's not messed up or anything. They're all good. They really wanted him in his life. And he was essentially, she was like, I don't want you guys. Like, never call them, never anything. Like, this is a new person. I just want this castle. I'm going to live on my own.
Psychopath.
Maybe that's the lesson is just don't, you know, you never know. Don't judge a book, I guess.
Like, oh, yeah. Don't judge a book by its cover or the story.
But you talk, his dad gave, like, one tiny subtle look. To where there was a flicker of like, I know my son's kind of fucked up thing there. Like, I don't know if you guys saw it.
It was
the most subtle look, but he was just like,
which
like,
one?
When they went to go visit.
Oh. You know what this reminds me? What? Anna Delvey.
Exactly. Yeah. Just a pathological liar that is failing.
Yeah. But Anna Delvey
just
like,
wants to be rich.
At least she didn't murder no one.
She didn't murder anybody to get it. Yeah.
Here's the thing too. He's almost got, aside from Rosamund Pike there at the end, he's like, oh, like, I gave him, like, I know he definitely murdered Felix. I'm not saying he didn't, but I'm saying, like, if it ever comes back, it's like plausible deniability. Yeah, I mean, we were doing drugs and partying. I don't know where he got the drugs from. And then with the.
But he blamed it on, what's his name?
Oh, yeah.
Cousin,
yeah.
Faith.
Why can't I say his name?
Farley. It's a regular name spelled weird because they're rich. Yeah. But then even with the like razors on the bathtub, it's like, I mean, put the razors there. But like she said, she wanted to say like he's just shitty, man. It feels like it's like secondhand murder to him.
Right?
Except for the last one. The last one was very hands-on, but everything else felt like, oh, I laid a trap in it and I walked away. And
I don't think he just left the razors there. He could have still slit her. Like he, maybe. Yeah, he placed it there, but I don't know.
I think a movie showed it. I don't think he did it. I think he
did the dad either, but like he could have done the dad somehow. They just didn't show it. But he just waited a really long time to do it.
Yeah, but I mean, maybe he knew the dad was sad enough. Maybe he's like, the dad's always been, he could just tell. He's like, he ain't got any friends or in a big house all by himself. So that motherfucker's gonna kill himself eventually. And when he does, I'll make sure I'm in the right place where I need to be.
I would like to know how calculated he was with everything else. I'm like, he may have done that.
I would like to know how much money he got from the dad to leave.
Yeah.
He got just enough to surpass him with those funds.
Yeah.
And then just planted himself in front of the mom.
Yeah. What was the date on the newspaper? Maybe we could see how long it was.
Yeah. Well, the only reason why I think he left the dad up to it or something like that is he wanted to give himself some space. Because it feels like for the whole time he was planting traps. Like
he was.
There was no 100% guarantee. I don't know what he put in. I'm assuming he put coke in the booze. Yeah. Maybe it was actual poison. But if it was actual poison, I don't know where the fuck he would have got it from. But I'm just like, there was no guaranteed hit that he was going to die. But he was like, I'm pretty sure this will work. And even with the sister, he like left the razor. He's like, there's no guaranteed hit that she'll do it, but I'm pretty sure she will. And I feel like with the dad, it was kind of the same way where he's like, it's not guaranteed, but I'm really, really hoping it works out. And I'll keep an eye out for it every day.
I bet the staff knew. They watched silently and everything. They were so happy when he left.
I think that is one way to look at it, but I think they were guaranteed hits because he started all the way from the bike.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And like, so that's how premeditated all this shit was. If he was going for the kill, he was going to make sure the kill went through.
So you think he was planning on killing them since he put that, he like punctured his bike and he's like, my plan is to kill you.
I was going to ask about that though. I think he actually did love homie. I think he did love Felix.
He was that... You know, though, he's
like
that guy from You. He's a stalker behavior where he's like really fixated on this person and he wanted to have this person no matter what the cost was. Mm-hmm. And then afterwards, not only like he was obsessed with the person, was also obsessed with like what it represented. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm going to take over everything. I'm going to be you. I'm essentially going to replace you and then like, take
before
everything.
You move on, check
did
out
did you
cup?
Think that like he just wanted to be his friend, but when he didn't want to be friends anymore, he... killed him.
Oh, it got Maze on it. For a second, I was Sandy.
What'd you say,
Myrna? Were you saying that, like, you thought he really wanted to be Felix's friend, but then when he didn't want to be friends anymore, he killed him?
I was going
to
ask you guys.
He would maybe live?
I think he was in love with the kid, and then when that was no longer a viable option, he's like, I'm just going to take your life. You know what I mean? Because like, I don't think he set out from the fact, like, ooh, there's a rich kid. He's with this family. I'm gonna come up with this whole scheme. Well, I think it was just like, I want to be in his person's life.
Well, he could have been married into the family. That could have also been a way to get the castle. Sure. For me, the thing's called Saltburn. And for me, I feel like he was like, I want Saltburn. Because you might be rich. You might be a billionaire, but you ain't got a fucking castle that goes back a couple of thousand years, do you?
I think that because of the name Saltburn, I think that movie really is about like how to get Saltburn.
Yeah.
And I think the only way to get Saltburn is this.
I bet there was more. If we go back and rewatch the scene where him and Farley are talking about their essays, I bet there were some hints right there too.
Yeah,
because like, you know, he may have learned about what's his name from Farley, and so on and so forth. Can you go to the scene with Oliver Quick's dad? I just want to see if I was seeing something or if
I think
there
it's
was a glimmer of like
right there. Yeah.
Oh yeah, my son's fucked up. Yeah, see, it was very. So he was just kind of looked away, like
he's like,
clearly he did
doing
not talk
shit.
About his sisters.
Like, that something happened.
So he's been a bad addict.
Yeah, he's been lying before. He has lied before. There must have been incidents. It's interesting how I love these kind of movies that brings up like so much discussion because you can see it interrupted like different ways.
I took it that he might be, the way I took it was that he's maybe like, he thinks, the dad thinks that like, oh, he's embarrassed of us. He just doesn't talk about us. Because they're like, they have a normal upbringing. Maybe they know a boy's rich. Maybe they can't tell or something like that.
But like, it's like, a nice house.
Oh, he's and he's at Oxford too. And Oxford's super fancy. Maybe he's like, oh, you go to Oxford and you just want to pretend like you don't fuck with your family no more. I didn't take it as in like, he's a liar. Like the dad knows. It could have. I took it as like some jealousy, not jealousy shit, but like
that.
Know,
that
like,
could be it too, because they're well off, but they're not like
they're middle class. They're perfectly
rich.
Middle class, bro. Like they have the gone fishing thing and shit. Like the wooden sign on the fucking wall.
Yeah, but then
tapestry.
Also, like the fact that like when he was at admissions, they didn't even know the name of his town. Like he was like a nobody from nowhere with no name. You know what I mean?
At a big school.
I think that's what was it kind of motivating him to be somebody and like just having the status and having the house and like just the name.
Yeah, that could be as like, oh, so I'm nobody here. Let me get the be the person who is someone. Yeah. How to get it? Well, let me just kill the people. I think he may have just started all of that to get in a good side of Felix and eventually like maybe marrying it out, like whatever, being there forever until like Felix realized that, well, this guy lied and I want to kick him out. It's like, okay, now I'm gonna take you by force. Mm-hmm. It just escalated from there, but he wanted that. He wanted,
and the more
to
I think about it, it's pretty brilliant.
Yeah,
like even Mathis,
oh yeah,
that's such a good saying, like he's gonna use you and then he's gonna dump you and you don't, I know his name wasn't Mathis. Michael
Mathis. Actually, yeah, Michael.
Like, he's gonna use you and dump you, and then he was maybe thought there, I'll use him.
Yeah,
you know, I'll make that work for me. Because yeah, no one paid attention to him when he was a nobody. Even if you're smart, even if you get a scholarship, you go into Oxford. Mm-hmm. If you're still a nobody, no one's gonna pay attention to you. So yeah. Like,
he's just a nobody. Thing to him after the bike thing, though, right? Yeah.
I'm wondering if he even had a scholarship or if his parents just paid for school. Like, I feel like everything was a lie.
I think he's smart enough to he is smart enough that there's a possibility that he had gotten small scholarship. Mm,
so what about that top of the class thing? You think that was bullshit? So the parents were like, oh, he's even top of the class. And we were all thinking like, oh, this dude's a super liar. What if he is top of his class? Well, what if he is literally the smartest motherfucker at Oxford?
But he's not rowing.
But what I'm saying is like, if you're the smartest motherfucker at Oxford, then maybe he did. He's like, I'm on some 30 level D chess shit. Like, I'm either marrying one of these motherfuckers or I'm killing them all, but I'm getting the castle.
I mean, it wasn't enough. He was smart, but like, it wasn't enough to be recognized even by like, the common person, you know what I mean? Even by his teachers, not even that respected.
Yeah, because of the legacy. Like, I think that's what he wanted.
But he's...
the smartness. Yeah.
We know he's not on the rowing team.
Yeah. Huh? Oh, yeah, the rowing team. I mean, but I'm saying, like, amongst that's all the lies, true, just because everything's a lie doesn't... Or just because most of the shit he says a lie doesn't mean everything. But I'm saying,
I would think that everything he said to his parents was a lie.
Yeah? Because even with...
I believe the scholarship, yeah. I don't believe top of the class. I don't believe...
In that scene with the professor... When he's like, he's reading his paper and shit, and the professor doesn't give a fuck because he's like, oh my God, you're Farley, what's his face's kid? I went to school with him, I'm like, legacy, right? Mm-hmm. Doesn't matter how smart homie is, doesn't matter where he's from. Like, this dude over here doesn't give a fuck, came in late, was probably smoking ciggies on the way here, smells like smoke, but because of his family name, it's like, whatever. And dude's like, oh, but I'm so smart, so he might have lied about it, but.
Yeah.
And then he was talking shit about like how he wrote too many thus in his essay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Which, I mean, he didn't even write an essay. So it's like, what are you talking about? And like,
it's like no one talks like that.
I mean, it would piss me off too, seeing if I'm like trying hard and like trying to have good grades and shit, and other people are passing just because of their name.
Yeah. And like, he didn't want to be relegated to like, damn, I got to be friends with the other nerdy kid and he's kind of insufferable. Like, this is not going to be my life.
Give me a song! Yeah. And he realized as soon as the first day when he sat down at a table and Matt was like, well, you know, like, look around us. Like, it's just two of us. Everybody have found their people because they came here for legacy. You know, I'm hearing about all you guys talk, I do think that maybe he did have a scholarship and he was in rowing team and all that stuff. He just didn't want Felix to know because he told Felix that how he just comes from this background that he didn't have anything like.
He was fit. He's fit enough to be on a rowing team.
Right? He does look like fit.
But then
enough
he would have
like,
made friends.
Huh?
You can't be on a sports team and be an active one and be a friend.
He wanted soccer.
He wanted soccer. You want a specific friend. Maybe
kinda
he was just
wild,
like,
bro. Castle, I mean, I guess it's baller to have.
But he was
Lex Luthor.
We would have seen him on this team.
Yeah, we had no scene of him doing anything.
Everything going by with a pot.
With water.
They showed what he did. He watched Homie have sex at school, and that's it. He cleaned up after him. He was a clean freak, which is also just, I guess, part of that personality.
Yeah.
Oh, he has OCD.
And we all thought it's because his drug addict parents.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
No, he just...
could just been an addition to embellish.
Yeah, it could have
the lie
further.
It
could be. Yeah, everything he played.
His lies were.
So, question
all 5D.
Is: was he playing everything from the first second we saw? The only way we find out is to watch again, and none of us are watching it again.
I might watch it with Corey.
Then you will notice all the things.
I'm not watching this
because
again.
Look, for him to have started from the bike, he found his target, did his research, put a nail in the tire, and then knew he was going to give him his bike just to start that relationship. Like,
yeah.
I think from there, he planned on getting to their stuff.
Ever since Mathis said that, like, whatever, he's like, all right, I'm going to find somebody.
I have an argument for top of the class. Mathis. He read all 50 of those books over the summer, and a dude was like, bro, you didn't need to do that. Mm-hmm. Fuck, maybe he lied about that too. Never mind. Fuck this kid.
Right, you know?
You know what? I'm glad he got his castle. I'm never going to the party.
He's a pathological liar, bro.
Yeah. He was like, oh shit, I shouldn't have said that because he just maybe like want people to just say it.
So all the like videos and TikToks that I got to see about this, like everybody's like very cryptic, like the scene, you know the scene. Yeah. And then like I knew exactly.
So several
like,
scenes.
Then like later on I knew about like the fucking cum tub. And I was like, okay. So they're talking about that. Sounds fun. But then
the grave happened.
They're like, if you know.
That's what I'm saying.
But like,
no,
what do you mean? There's so many scenes that were so bad.
Huh?
It was three. Let's get a triptych of that. The blood and the grave.
Spidey can foreshadow so well. So when he just said that, I'm like, nah. Dude. No.
Spidey, we're going to make a movie together, bro.
What? Oh, my God.
I just can't believe they gave him free reign like that to do like a the scene. And then he was like, I'm going to pull out my dick.
Yeah, I mean.
They did a good job laying out the clues, though. Because like I saw everything coming right before. But like right before it happened. So like, and it was still just like, no, he's not going to do this, is he? Oh, he did that.
Yeah, you hope.
Technically, his hands are clean.
I mean, no.
He ripped out that.
Besides that, and also who knows what accident actually happened with her.
I didn't know clean hands. Like, he deliberate.
Just like did it all that.
Those first two were definitely second degree murder.
First two were second degree. Yeah, he was just like, here,
he left the banana peel at the top of the stairs and a bunch of swords at the bottom and just walked away.
I was just cleaning and just happened to be there.
Right.
Well, you guys didn't check. How about you guys let us know what you thought about this movie and if you would ever Rube Goldberg murder your way to getting a castle.
You know, he's got a castle now, so we're talking shit over here.
Right. Honestly, he represents exactly what I think about all billionaires.
That he murdered his way into the castle?
A couple bodies back there.
Little finger did that. Damn.
Yep.
All right, we'll see y'all at the next movie reaction.
Bye.